do not for one man, but for the good of all mankind.
Pierced the New York skyline at a dizzying 1,250 feet and was the crowning achievement of skyscraper building until the latter half of the 20th century.
Hey.
New York, New York, the town so nice, they named it twice. Here in New York City is a little different.
Population, 8.2 million people.
Good morning, everyone. And with us today are some of the world famous Rockettes.
The city that never sleeps.
Madison Square Garden, located in the heart of Manhattan, is the venue for shows.
New York's got a lot of things going for it.
I'm in a New York state of mind.
Moments in my life as a broadcaster that I go, ah,
this is why I do this. And going up to Rockland County that night to host the Zoom call with Darius was one of them, because I walked into the firehouse. These are all just great guys. They're all volunteers. Jared was a volunteer. They do this for the community. They do this because they have a brotherhood and a camaraderie, and they really love each other. And I walked in, and in their communal area, in their bar area, they have a stool with all of Jared's, his stuff, and there's a candle lit, and his boots are there, and his jacket's there, and then Darius calls, and it was really, I don't know, it felt like that moment when, well, here's kind of how we talked about it on the air, and I'd love to share it with you. It's close to being there as I can get you. I personally feel like God, the universe, puts people in our path for a reason. Last night is a great example of that. Honestly, to be part, even this teeny part, of honoring and remembering a fallen hero, a fallen firefighter, Jared Loy, from Colombian Fire Company Number 1.
Jared was like the guy with a constant smile on his face. He always, always had a smile on his face.
And he loved country music. His youngest son is Darius.
They mentioned how cool it would be to be able to connect with Darius Rucker. And you were up there last night to help make sure that happened. And I can only imagine what it was like to be in that room when Darius Rucker popped up on that Zoom and was able to connect.
There's sadness and tears, but there was some joy last night with the sing-along.
So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me.
And they just all sang, and it was pretty amazing. And then I just, I don't know, Jonah knows this. This is the weirdest thing. I didn't even talk about this on the air, but I went to the funeral. I just, as a fly on the wall, went up and went to the funeral.
Well, I think that speaks to, I mean, your heart, Kelly, and really that how genuine you are, because when you say something, you mean it. And when you want to support somebody, you do. And I think there are a lot of instances of people in the spotlight doing things for an image or doing things because they think they should. But you did it because your heart called you to. And again, you said we didn't even talk about that on the radio because it was something that you felt needed to be done. And it was because you had this bond with these people and you weren't just going to check some thing off a box and say, yeah, we're a first responder station, so we're going to do this thing. It's in your heart. It's in your soul. And that it's seen by everybody, but to also be able to work with you these last few months and see that and learn from that has been really inspirational. And I know that you've made these lifelong bond with these guys now because of this.
Well, it feels cool that Eric and Timothy and all those guys trusted me to tell to share Jared's story. And for a minute, you know, also they said we were like, well, we don't want to exploit it. And then they're like, no, we want the story told. We want his legacy to live on. And that's kind of what we're doing today here. And speaking of first responders, I want to bring up Todd Van Duren of Ramsey Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram. And yes, that sounded like a plug because it kind of is. Because Todd has really sponsored so many things and been so supportive of first responders and First Responder Friday. And that takes money. And you supporting Kelly Ford in the Morning, First Responder Friday, and so many of the things that we've done here at New York's Country 94.7, Todd, thank you. It means more than you could possibly know.
Hello?
Hello, Todd. You're on.
Hey,
how are you?
How are you guys?
Good.
Hi. Well, listen, it's been just such a pleasure to work with all you guys, know all you guys, and, you know, a few minutes ago, somebody called me and talked to me about first responder, and they said, well, you know, we can maybe. I said, no. First responder is the people at 94.7. Okay, that's what made it. That's what made it special. You guys just, you know, it was so awesome. And I have a lot of support. You know, my wife is a nurse, and you know what she went through during the pandemic and all that kind of stuff. And the way you guys supported this whole thing and all that you did was just so awesome. And it's just been, you know, I go back so far with you guys, and you know, Jesse and I go back, I think, from the beginning, and John and Kelly, and it's just, Katie was, you know, I dealt with Katie a little later on in my stint with you guys, but I just, you guys just have just been so awesome and so much fun to work with. I was thinking about it before, and I don't know if you guys remember this, but we were in doing one of my commercials and producing, and we were having a little bit too much fun, and they overheard us doing the traffic on one of the radio stations, and we all got taken to the principal's office and spoken to, and that was just, we just had so much fun doing that. I hope you guys remember that. That was just, you know.
Actually, I got to tell you, Todd, Dave Plotkin is in the room, believe it or not, so you have to, I just had to put headphones on.
I need to give me a little more energy on that one.
Dave Plotkin, for everybody listening, is a producer at 1010 Wins, and he does the commercials with Jesse, Katie, and me, and Todd. So retell that story to him. He didn't hear it.
You know, well, Dave, you know, I don't know if you remember the, you know, right before the pandemic, when I would come in and do a lot of stuff live with you guys, mm-hmm. when we were just having a little bit too much fun in your office, and they were doing the traffic, and we all got spoken to, we all got taken to the principal's office because we were being a little too loud, and they overheard our joy on the traffic report on 1010.
That's
and,
true.
That was just, it was so much fun. And Dave, you know, what you, you know, a couple of weeks ago, I, you know, this is Dave, okay? I was doing my commercial remotely, and I was actually out of town, and I was sitting at a desk, and he's like, is there a bed in the room? I'm like, what do you mean? He goes, go lay on the bed and put your face by the bed on the microphone. It'll sound better.
Stop at no expense to make a 10, but I will tell all everybody this. The beauty of radio is really that creativity, and as a creative director, my favorite thing is to play off with the true professionals like Katie, Jesse, Kelly, and Todd, and really make a story and tell a story and have fun, because Todd's more than client. He's family. Mm-hmm. He's 94.7 family. And mm-hmm. I think that that's what was so special about that. And to the listeners, that's what's so special about this radio station. So you bond with so many people. It's not just the radio people. It's the sponsors. It's the listeners. And to be able to tell that story and bring creativity to life, and kudos to John Fox for letting us do that. And we'll really miss you. This was just a real blast. Todd, what a pleasure.
I remember, guys, you know, way, way back, okay, and this sounds, you know, not that far ago, but when Jesse and I first started doing the commercials, I just came in and spoke, but Jesse, we would be in the PLJ studio, and Jesse did the whole deal. I mean, he recorded it, produced it, this, that, we'd go back and forth, and it was just, you know, and that's where I first learned how to do a lot of the stuff that I do now with Jesse. We had so much fun. You know, we would take the copy and mess around with it and all that kind of stuff and change things. And I just, you know, I just can't thank you guys. You guys just, it's been, you know, you're my friends. It's, you know, I know it's a business relationship first, but more importantly, you guys are my friends. And I just, I'm going to miss you guys. I love you guys so much. And I just, you know, I want the best for all of you, and I know that, you know, you guys will find something hopefully, you know, bigger and better, and it'll just be awesome because...
I'll say this about Todd, and I texted him, thanks for keeping the lights on. I think Mary Jo could go do the books. I think Todd Van Duren,
yes.
Ramsey Chrysler, Jeep Dodge Ram,
oh my God,
is single-handed responsible for at least 1 year of this radio station being on the air. Single-handedly. You the man.
Well, thank you, guys. And like I said, it's been really great, and, you know, I'm sad. You know, mm-hmm. because it's just been such a all of the programs that we've done, and like I said, you know, first responders has been awesome, and doing the commercials with all you guys, and all the sponsorships and all the fun we've had, and I just can't thank you guys enough, and I wish you all the best, and I know we'll stay friends, and you know, and
we shall meet again.
Stay in touch. We absolutely will, and John, you know, John, especially John Fox too, for all the antics to let that go on and all that kind of stuff, but it made the commercials were real, they were believable, they were, you know, they, people listened to them, they're like, it just sounded, you guys were just like, you know, whatever, but that's what made it fun, and that's what made them so believable, and you guys, you know, just, you know, made me feel so comfortable and a part of your crew there. And you know, I remember, you know, the pizzas Fridays, I would come in, we have the pizza outside, you know, on the bar.
New York
out
pizza
there.
Suprema.
Suprema's the best.
Exactly, you know, and I mean, even that, I mean, just, it would just be the luck of the draw when you come in and you're sitting there at pizza and someone would walk by you like, whoa, you know, who was that? Or who was it? The people that I got to meet, and you guys, you know, just made me feel so part of that, and I just can't thank you enough.
Well, Todd, and I got to thank you, too. I would say, no kidding, not in the air, and I would use you as an example, actually, because, you know, part of the thing was, right, we all rallied around each other. So Katie and Jesse and Kelly, they were all just part of everyone's show, right? And I would always say, I said, if Todd and this advertiser wants to use the power of all three of these talents, right? I go, we're clearly doing something right.
Yes.
And you really rallied around this team and these on-air personalities. And I just thought that was incredible. I used to say that all the time. I'm like, we're clearly doing something incredible, right? I go, he can't wait to get all the DJs all involved because they have just such great chemistry together to just share great stories, you know? And, right, you're selling products.
Awesome. Awesome.
And they're here to talk about the radio station. But I thought it was just really remarkable on just the level of support and investment that you made in the people that ran this property.
And I have to thank you for my Jeep named Betty.
For Betty.
Right?
For Betty.
We just celebrated our one-year anniversary together.
Well, even all my guys were all texting me, and girls were all texting me, like, you know, for the dealership. They're like, what do you mean? What do you mean? They're just, you know, as heartbroken as I am.
That's so crazy. You know, but we appreciate you, all your support all along, and we're going to meet again. It's all good,
yes,
Todd. Todd Van Duren, Ramsey Chrysler, right, Jeep Dodge Ram. We love you.
All the best. Love you guys.
So
okay,
fun hearing from so many people today. We've got the whole crew in here. It's Kelly Ford, Jesse Addy from Afternoons. Got Katie Neal in here as well. Today is the last day. New York's Country 94.7. I know now. I think finally I'm like drying up. It might be time to start thinking about shutting her down. People, is it time, John Fox? It's getting close.
Yeah, we're getting there, and I know we have another special guest that we're trying to get connected to us now.
Mm-hmm.
Joan is working on it. Somebody who wants to really talk to you.
One more thing I do want to bring up. It might be coming on. We did talk to Amy O'Sullivan. Oh, I want to bring back up St. Jude. We had St. Jude call in earlier, and I think this is a great opportunity. Mel Bird from St. Jude. She mentioned that in the few years we did St. Jude. Is it 3 years total, guys?
3 years? Two or three.
It was 2 years, and we did three radiothons, though.
Yeah. We packed it in there.
Yeah,
we got it in there. Made over $1 million. This was the last total.
We have raised... What? $404,732.
You did it!
That was so cool.
We asked so much in such a short time of the listeners of the Tri-State, and you came through over and over again. So this morning is kind of one last gasp of just trying to make a difference, because that's what we've done and we want to continue to do as people. If you would like to make a donation to St. Jude, if you're sad that New York's Country 94.7 is going away, man, if it speaks to your heart, hit them up. 800-822-6344. And we can pop that on our socials, right? Are we allowed to do that? 800-822. We can do it on our personal socials anyway. 800-822-6344. 800-822-6344. I would like to go around the room and just let everybody, since we're all going to be looking for employment and followers, have a chance to give their socials out. I'm the Kelly Ford, as in THEKELOYFOR. Jonah?
Well, it seems like a lie now, but it's Jonah on the radio. J-O-N-A-H on the radio.
Sabrina?
Mine is Sabrina from Queens, because I will always be Sabrina from Queens.
Mine is Hey Katie Neal, HEYKATIENEAL.
Jess, your turn.
At Jesse Addy, JESSEADDY. Can I want to just... thank some people real quick.
Yep.
Robbie Caruggio, Pub 46, Mother's Ale House as well. John and Patty at the Cornerstone in Hillsdale. Some unbelievable nights with them. Joe and the staff at Nutty Irishman, Farmingdale. They had a DJ, a karaoke band, and a band. It was crazy what they would do. House of Q in Hoboken. So many fun times there, too. Jason always welcomed us at the door at Irving Plaza. Everybody, Webster, Gramercy, Bowery, Michelle at MSG. I mean, the list goes on. We don't have time for all these people. All the super fans. Yankee Steffi, that loves Scotty McCree, Don Antonelli, Luke Bryan's number one fan, Carrie Tracy, the Wayne Tailgate Crew, everybody at Hill Country
Take your time, Barbecue. Dude. We got time. Let's all do some shout-outs to our friend. Yeah, I think that's a great thing to do. Nikki, I just mentioned the Colombian Fire Company. Eric said, come see us tomorrow. We can cheer you up, Kelly Ford. Love you. Jenny D, Rob Fulmer, Keisha, Mark Chernoff texted me, Cliff Blake, Sue Falco, Lindsay Church, Scott King, Tim Hill, Ty Bentley. He can't get through, but Ty Bentley from Ty Kelly and Chuck, Joe Nolan, who did Traffic, Nick Palmera from the Firehouse, our Firehouse right around the corner, Holly from Robin Holly, our night show. We got Fletcher, Lindsay L. Oh, I really should check. I've got 125 new text messages. So, yeah.
And just one more time to mention all our famous friends who have been with us for so long on the station and have been amazing. And our Facebook group, as you can imagine, has been going on fire this morning. We will give you a full video recap message later on, but just to Susan Evans and Brian Victoria, famous friend number one's been in the chat today, Stephanie, Lynn, Matthew Thomas, Jessica, Susan again, Lucia. It's just so many people have been posting favorite photos that we've taken together.
Nice.
Just going down memory lane, and we'll show there is still a way to get a little bit of country. We can share that with you in our group.
Andrew Lava from NYPD wrote
that was
in.
The one I was trying to think of. I also want to say, like, you guys have named so many people that you wanted to thank, but there's one person that I want to make sure that I do get to give a shout out to, and that is Sweet Anthony from Brooklyn. For as long as I have been on the radio.
Me too.
Anthony, I hope you're listening. Anthony has called every day, and he always has the sweetest things to say, and he always wants to check in on me and make sure I'm okay, and I'm doing well, and
he kind of wants to marry you.
He does. He's asked me before. He's so sweet. And Jesse and I have just spent a lot of time talking to him, and when I was thinking about people I'm just gonna miss his pleasant voice every
day.
He's
a sweet boy.
Anthony, we love you.
We love you so much. We can get to more shout-outs for sure. We take our time, honestly.
Yeah.
We
really can. I just want to say thanks to a couple people, too, because, you know, listen, you guys, I know this is really tough, and our time is really coming to an end here. So just thank you. Thank you for sharing all the time with us and really sharing your lives with me. And there's a lot of people behind the scenes. Dan Kelly is a guy who loves radio so much, and he is really one of the biggest backbones of this whole entire operation, from production and imaging, but really just like a great friend and a great coach to everybody. Dan, you've been just an incredible human being. Thank you for everything. I got to give a special thanks to Tim Roberts, you know, General Roberts, our big-time country leader, and Kevin Callahan on the West Coast. We got an incredible team, too. Justin Cole and Scott Roddy and Marcy, who've just been so incredible and influential in what we do here behind the scenes. And I want to give another shout-out to a great friend of mine who's become a great friend of mine, actually, and a tremendous colleague, Clay Walker, who is here too. But Clay works so hard, not only for our radio station, for every radio station in this company. I mean, hours and hours and hours and just countless so many responsibilities to make us sounding good. And, you know, we went through hell here in the pandemic. And I got to thank Scott Colombo and the engineering team and Kenny and IT and everybody here at 345, because we did not miss a beat when the world stopped. And they kept the lights on and they kept it open and they kept everything available and accessible to us. Oh, and Matt Weller here, too, who runs the front desk, who supplied all the studios with cleaning supplies, right? And followed all these protocols.
So we're going to steal on the way out.
Right, and people had to do the impossible at the time, right? Think about it. If you go back to March, it was, you know, the things that we had to do. And that's it. You know, this on-air team and Sabrina from Queens and Mike Allen and Kelly and Katie and Jesse and Robin Holly and Coop.
Coop, there it is.
I could go on forever and ever. But,
you want to hit Race Taylor real quick?
I'm going to say thank you to Chris Olivero for really, you know, for letting us do this today. So
I know Chris fought hard to let us do this. It means a lot. And we said earlier today, it feels good. I mean, they didn't have to let us do this. And it means a lot that we got to do it. And I think it speaks to, we did leave it all out there. Everybody did work really hard to fight to keep this station. And so thank you for recognizing that.
And obviously, thanks to Audacy, because, you know, a little behind the scenes, when this radio station got bought, everyone I knew in the industry was surprised that, A, it was still a country station, and B, we were still involved. So shout out to everybody who gave us an extra 2.5 years. David Field, Susan Larkin, who was the greatest ambassador for us just as people. And I'm so happy people got to hear John Fox and be in the Fox meeting, basically.
In the foxhole.
It's why everyone on the radio right now would just go through a wall for John Fox. And
what he did to get us from
one building to the other was just unbelievable. Thank you.
John Fox really, I have to say, like, he put a dream into my life, the dream that I didn't even know could possibly exist. He really took me under his wing and made something for me. And that's something that I'll always be grateful for, because you put a light in my life that I'll never be able to dim. So.
Love you, Sabrina.
This crew, I'm telling you, look around this room, and there are, as John said earlier, this is a dream.
Countless, and I'm forgetting people like Rachel McGrath and Scott Fisher and Michelle Drago, and I could go on and on and on about the people who...
Dave Flack,
did you say... Cicely Warrington.
Hold on a second. You know what we got to do? We got to give a big shout-out to our special squad up crew, Jessica Clark.
Oh, I was going to say, did you say Jess Clark?
Jessica
Clark is another superstar here at the radio station, not only for 94.7 for so many things inside the company, but Jessica Clark too, you know, gets that phone call of a new station and all this work, and we really just all jumped in together, and we were standing around one time, and she's just like, you know, you guys are just so cool, and we're all like, you know, loving on each other, and it's like, you know, when one great squad, you know, meets another great squad, you know, and she goes, you squad up. And that's exactly what we did.
Listen.
And I love you so much, Jess. And
Jess
really, and
is everything.
And Jar, you will forever be Jar in my life. Jeannie and Raquel. And hey, Fox, here's Baby Girl. So shout out to Baby Girl. I don't even know you that much, Baby Girl, but what's up? Mm-hmm. I love you too, and know you through your friends. But again, and I'm really sorry if I'm. If I'm leaving anyone out yet, Lauren,
George,
I could go on forever and ever.
And again, one more big
April
shout
Shibley,
out.
Hey,
oh
Marissa,
yeah, all the way
Neil
back
Dillon.
To the old school days. Yeah. But yeah, it has been a ride. Everything, I guess, comes to an end. I had an intuition way back when, and I would say this to everybody in the room. I told this to Katie yesterday. Change is it's inevitable, and it comes, and you can embrace it or you can fight it. And if you embrace it and enjoy the ride, it's all gonna be okay. We're gonna be okay. I promise this.
We are.
Just
a shout out to Kevin Jonas too.
Yeah, what's up, Kevin?
Thanks, Kevin Jonas, for being a judge on Nash Next.
You can't go out on Kevin Jonas.
But I'm just saying, we're looking around the room.
Yes, we can.
And I think this is going to be it. And I think we're going to fire this song off here in a second. What do you think, Kelly? Are you ready?
I need to say something to you guys before we go, because I will regret this. First of all, to John. You gave me a job, and you believed in me in a time when I know you put your own career on the line so that I could have a chance to do this, and I will never forget that, and I am so grateful for you.
Well, I'm so grateful for you.
And Kelly, you put the dream in my heart. You said to me when you were leaving, you said, you know, you should do my job. And I didn't get to do it for a while later, but I thought that was the craziest thing that you even thought at that point that I was capable of doing it. Just yet, I can't even look at you on Zoom, because... I could not have made it through the last 4 years without you. I mean, getting to work with this team of people has just been... Like, everyone always says, the team in New York is just different, and you guys, it has been different, and I love you so much. So much. You mean the world to me.
You're the best, Katie. You're the best.
Jess?
I just want to say, do you hear that love amongst us? And if you... If you ever listen to this radio station, you're like, do they feel that way about each other, that they act like on the radio, or when they're hanging out with artists, or when they come to, you know, the shows and they're hanging out at our tailgates? Yes. We meant every word of it. On the air and off. I don't mean to get too emotional, because this has been, you know, the highlight of my career, but I love all these people, and
And we'll tell these. I mean, we had a few hours here. We will tell the stories of you as a listener and the artist and what we did for the rest of our lives.
You created this.
New York.
You made our dreams come true. And when I walked out the door this morning, I'm like, today is going to be perfect. It is the rare moment when there's no wrong answers. Today was perfect. So I guess since I was the first live voice heard on New York's Country 94.7, I will be the last live voice heard on New York's Country 94.7, and we will sign off with the very first song. I mean, not officially sign off, but how about we sign off all these live, beautiful people with the very first song that we signed on with on January 21st, 2013. Remember this, guys? This is how country feels! New York's Country 94.7!
I love you, New York!
Hey, this is Carrie Underwood on New York's Country 94.7.
New York's Country 94.7. Baby, you a song and you make me want to roll my windows down and cruise.
Nash-FM and HD1 Newark. An Audacy station.
Always in an impious state of mind.
Testing. 1, 2, 3.
From the Lincoln Tunnel to the Holland Tunnel. From the LIRR to Metro North. From New Jersey Transit to the PATH Train. From the GWB to the Throgs Neck Bridge. From the Major Deegan to the Whitestone Bridge. From the BQE to the Verrazano. From JFK to Newark Airport. From LaGuardia Airport to the Brooklyn Bridge. Everything you want is right here.
Together. New York City, the concrete jungle, the place where dreams are made. Bright lights, big city, the place where hip-hop was born. The Bronx, Harlem, Brooklyn, Queens, Mount Vernon, Staten Island, Long Island, New Jersey, and New York. From the projects to the suburbs, hip-hop and R&B became a way of life. Uptown Records, Bad Boy Records, Def Jam Records, and more. Ralph McDaniels on Video Music Box. Fab Five Freddy on MTV. And this man, Ed Lover on MTV.
Yo, this is Ed Lover. Today, the time has come to usher in a brand new chapter in New York radio. During the last few months, we've talked to and listened to thousands of New Yorkers about what you want from a new radio station. A station that is designed by New Yorkers exclusively for New York. You've told us you want a radio station that plays music you don't hear enough of. Songs like this. Or like this.
Yo, can I get a what, cause chickens from all of my-
my thugs who don't love dough, they get no dough.
And I'm going to go out and get me, and I'm gonna take my time. Don't fight that good. Let me blow you.
Music that makes you feel alive. Music that makes you remember.
Stand by. You've just discovered a radio station that will take you to new places, and many that sound remarkably familiar. Hip-hop and R&B always makes you feel a certain type of way. The memories will come back to you immediately. Set your preset to 94.7 The Block.
New York.
New York.
Welcome to a brand new sound. Welcome home to the new 94.7 The Block. New York's number one for throwbacks.
And commercial free.
Yeah, yeah, I'm out at Brooklyn. Now I'm down in...